Today I'm going to take a look at Triton's single and twin gang box cutters for plasterboard. What's happening now? I'm on my own. Here at eFIXX, we love products that save electricians time. And in a previous video, I took on Joe with a pad saw against this here, which is the Quadsaw, in order to cut single and twin boxes into plasterboard walls. And we suggested at the end of that video, the Quadsaw could save electricians time. However, you as the viewers gave us feedback saying it might save us time, Gaz. However, for what it cost, you didn't think it was justified. Therefore, I jumped online and went to an online retailer with next day delivery and got myself a couple of these. I got a twin and a single box from Triton Tools. These are designed to cut the same hole sizes into plasterboard to facilitate our one and two gang boxes. So let's take a look at the tool in action. So let's fit the Triton box cutter. I'm going to remove my blade from my multi-tool as I would normally. Just pull the pin out for me, drop my new box cutter in. I found it easier when I was doing these after I'd done a couple, just to put it on a slight angle. I think it made it easier for me just also to keep out of the way when I was recording it. So there we go, got it into position so I can cut my single boxes out. You'll notice that there's two tabs on it as well to grip into the plasterboard to stop it moving around when you start the cutting process as well. So let's do a single box. So designed for plasterboard only. So wiggle as I go. I've got my gloves on, goggles and mask. There's gonna be a lot of dust created. And as you see, I'm flexing it side to side as I go in order that I can cut it and clear the dust, plasterboard dust at the same time. So pop, through we go. We'll do a twin socket next. So I've changed it over exactly the same. You see I've got a slight angle now. I found it easier to do it like that. Lots of people have said to me that when they're doing this, it can destroy the back of the plasterboard. We'll look at that at the end, see what's happened to the back of it. But here we go, so through with the twin one. Another option as well that was suggested online was just to start the actual cutting process and finish it off with either a pad saw or a multi-tool blade. We'll get to that as well. So if we've got this one here, doing a twin socket box, so it gave me the perfect shape. And then I just finish it off with my multi-tool itself. I do fine with the multi-tool, sometimes I drift beyond the lines that I've marked on with pencil. So just nip that through, could have been a pad saw. Obviously it's easier, we've got a multi-tool out just to use that, just to clear that. Push that one through. Of course, I've got the option of using just the multi-tool. So here we go, another one. I can generally sometimes drift beyond the lines. So I'm trying to keep it in as best as I can. There we go, just slipped out the line there slightly. Again, another option if you want to use the multi-tool on its own, but again, the square cutters do give you the perfect size. Next, it's going to pop in a box. So in this case, dry line box, and it goes, and then we'll have a look at the back of the plasterboard. I did find it a bit hit and miss. So sometimes it wasn't too bad, other times it destroyed more of it. That's when I went straight through with the cutter. Hopefully you can clearly see there, we listened to your feedback. There were some pros and cons to using this Triton Tools cutter, but I think if you had it in your toolbox and you used it maybe in only for that template, it's going to give you the perfect twin and single box size every time you go into that installation where you're cutting away at plasterboard. As always at eFIXX, we're interested in your feedback, and this video illustrates the fact we listened to that feedback. So have you used these Triton Tools cutters before? Are the blades any good? Do they last a long time? Something that we don't know at the moment. We're always interested in your feedback. If you leave that feedback below, we'll react to it. Hopefully it'll help other people on the channel. Is there any other tools you'd like us to look at, maybe that come from a well-known online retailer that offer next day delivery? Please leave those comments below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.